हेलो एवरीवन, आई किरण मुकुंद्रा, वेलकम टू यू इन अवर नेक्स्ट लेक्चर एमरेंथेसिस फैमिली। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी डिस्कस अबाउट द सिस्टमेटिक पोजीशन अकॉर्डिंग टू बेंथम एंड हुकर क्लासिफिकेशन। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल किंगडम, देयर कैरेक्टर, ऑटोट्रॉपिक मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन मीन्स दे आर मेड अप ऑफ फूड by self because they have a chlorophyll are present. The cell wall is made up of cellulose. No locomotion, only movement occurrence. It means ke then plants are a not a location, yani ki not a changes of this place, but they are a only occurrence of movement. Then the division is a spermatophyta to produce a flower during the life cycle. Then after the fertilization, ovule turning to seed. It means ke seed are formation and then embryo formation occurrence. It means embryo are also formation in this family. Then the class are dicotyledons. The root are a taproot system. Two cotyledons are present, so it is called the dicotyledons. Venation is a reticulate. It means the lame in the leaf, the veins are arranged in the net like structure. Then the flower are generally pentamerous or tetramerous. Then after the fertilization, ovary convert into fruit. Then subclass Monoclemidae. In this Monoclemidae, the flower with the simple perianth, which is usually sepaloid and incompletely. It means ke replacement of the calyx and corolla, the perianth are present. So the calyx and corolla do not much differ in the shape and color. They are collectively, it means they are fused together, they known as the perianth, and they are generally sepaloid. It means the tepals are generally green in color and resemble with this sepal, so it is called the sepaloid. Then the flower is incomplete because they either calyx and corolla athwa to sometime the both are absent. Then the next series Curvembryae. In the series Curvembryae, the embryo are curved, flower are generally bisexual, and in this series the seven family are included, but in our syllabus the Amaranthesis and Polygonaceae both are family are included in this order. So today we discuss about the family of Amaranthesis. First of all, the introduction. In this, the plant are very commonly found in the Africa region and our India region. They are most often found in the temperate region. In our country and the other several species are cultivated as the ornamental plant because the most of the in our India, they are cultivated as a traditional ornamental plant. Vegetative character and floral character are included in this family. So first of all we discuss about the vegetative character. In the vegetative character, the habitat is mostly they are grown in the temperate region. Then the habit in this, the plant are a herb and shrub. They mostly annual or perennial herb and tree are red. Means in this family included, the plant are a very small in size, so it is called the herb. Then the moderate side, it is called the shrub. In this, the weak stem are present and they are annual and perennial. It means some plant are seasonal per year, so it is called the annual, and some plant are a seasonal continuous their life cycle, so it is called the perennial. And the tree are mostly absent, but in some species though, so tree are rare. Then the root are a taproot and branch system. Then the stem are aerial, herbaceous, erect, cylindrical, branch and hairy. It means the stem have a erect or cylindrical hai, branch structure hai. Then they are a herbaceous, it means the evergreen hai, because the most of them are shrub plant, and in on this stem the small hair structure are present. Then the leaves are generally simple, alternate or opposite, decussate, then petiolated, stipulate and reticulate venation. The leaves are generally simple, means they are a single leaf, not a group together. So then the alternate means when a single leaf arise at each node and arrange in a alternately. It means the stem have a two portion, node portion and internode. So the node and node between the two nodes, the internode are present. But when the node are present, the leaf are arise. Then after the second node, then leaf are arise. So they are alternately arrangement. It is called the alternate leaf. Then the opposite, it's called the leaf. Pair of leaf are arranged on a axis on a opposite side, and the further opposite have a two types. So in this leaf, the opposite decussate. The opposite decussate means a pair of leaves are arranged at each a node and the straight right angle to next pair above and below. It means that the main axis in this leaf, pair of leaf are arranged. But example of the first pair arranged in the right angle above side. So the lower below, they are arranged in this below side. So it is called the opposite decussate. Then the petiolated, it means that on the leaf portion the petiole are present. Then the ex-stipulate means the stipule are absent. Then venation is a reticulate. It means on the leaf the veins are arranged on a net like structure. Then the floral character. In this floral character, the inflorescence, first of all, usually racemose type, they may be simple or a branch spike or a raceme. So in this, the most of are a racemose type. So in this spike, the spike means the flower are a sessile. It means the petiole are absent. They are directly attached to the main axis and they are arranged in acropetal succession order on the main axis. And the spike is a modified into racemose flower. The flower is a bracteolate, hermaphrodite, actinomorphic and hypogynous. It means the bract and bracteolate both are present. Hermaphrodite means the bisexual, androecium and gynoecium both are present. Then the actinomorphic, it means the equal symmetrical, they are a regular flower. Then hypogynous, it means the ovary is a superior. The ovary are present in the above the sepals, petals and. Then the perianth. So the perianth is a dry, white or colored. It consists of 4 to 5 perianth leaves and sometimes 2 to 3. And the aestivation is quincial. So what is a perianth? The perianth, it means the calyx and corolla does not differentiated into sap and colors, but they are fused together. So it is called the perianth. So the perianth is a, in this figure we saw that the perianth is a, perianth is a dry and they are in some species they are white and colored. They are consist of 4 to 5 perianth leaves and sometimes 2 to 3. In the amaranthus genus, they are a number of 2 to 3. In the perianth, aestivation is a quincaceal. So quincaceal aestivation means in these 4 or 5 petals, example of their 5 petals aestivation. So in this 5 petal aestivation, the two perianth are arranged in an internal side and two are a external side and one partially internal and partially external arrangement. So it is called the quincaceal estimation. Then the androecium, it is a male portion. It consists of 4 or 5 stamen. They are situated opposite the perianth leaves and they mostly in there are 2 cells. They are a dioecious. It means ke jo perianth wala portion hai, perianth leaves attached hai, uske opposite mein stamen है उसका formation होता है और they are mostly 2 cell level. So it is called the dioecious. Then the gynoecium, it means the ovary portion. It consists of 2 or 3 ovary. When the 2 carpel are present, so it is called the bicarpellary. When the 3 carpel are present, so it is called the tricarpellary. In some places, in some plant they are bicarpellary, but in the some plant they are a tricarpellary. They are a syncarpous ovary. They are a syncarpous, means they are a fused together. Then the ovary is a superior. Then a unilocular, it means the single locular. Basal placentation, it means the arranged in the basal portion. And the stigma are 2 or 3. In the bicarpally, they have a 2. And the tricarpally, they have a 3. Then the fruit are a most of the nut, drupe and berry sap. Then the seed are endospermic, means they are formation in the inner side. Then pollination is entomophilic, it means the by insects. Then we discuss then the flower formula. So we discuss about the already in this flower person, the bract are present, so it is called the BR. Then the bracteolate, it is called the BRL. Then the flower are actinomorphic. Then bisexual, Then the calyx and carola absent, but they are different. It is called the perianth. They are of 4 to 5 in number. They are same to anther, 4 to 5 number. And the ovary, gynoecium, is a either bicarpellary, either tricarpellary. They are syncarpal, so it is the breaking number. And the ovary is a superior. So this is a floral formula. On this floral formula, we draw the floral flower are present. They are inflorescence. They are simple. Alternator leaf are arrangement, they are flower, and then the ovary section in this is the unilocular ovary. So on this floral formula, we discuss about the bract and bractulate are present. So the bract and the bractulate are present. They are the sepaloid are arranged in a 5, and the estivation is a quinquefacial estivation. Then the anther are 4 to 5 in number, and they are joined together. Then ovary is a unilocular and bicarpally, in flower is a actinomorphic. So this is a floral diagram arrangement. Then the next one is a example of the Amaranthus spinosus. It is called, they are the scientific name, but in this plant the male flower and the female flower both are different. So in this, first of all, the bractulate and actinomorphic are same plant, but they are bisexual. It means that the and the perianth is a both are same 5-5 number. Then and the androecium in the male flower, the androecium is a 4 or 5 number, and the gynoecium in the means the ovary are absent. Whether then is the female floral formula, in this the androecium is absent and the gynoecium is a bicarpellary and syncarpal. This is some example of this Amaranthus family. So first of all is the Amaranthus paniculatus, then the Ascarithens aspera, Amaranth spinosus. They are commonly wild distribution in our area. In this, the stipule, the spine is the spine are present. Then the Deucera, Muricata, then the Celosia argentea, they mostly grow in the hotter side. Thank you all.